Hello everyone. In the last video, we have seen the buccal cavity. So, buccal cavity is the first part of the digestive system where we take the food. The teeth will grind the food, the tongue that will mix the food with the saliva, and that saliva will be produced by the salivary glands. So, these things we have discussed. After that, we will see the next part of the buccal cavity. So, the next part of the buccal cavity is the pharynx. So, first of all, let me tell you how what is the pharynx, and after that I will tell you the different parts. Already I have written the three parts of the larynx region, that is known as the nasopharynx, the laryngopharynx and the oropharynx, right? So, let's see first of all where the pharynx and how the pharynx actually is present, right? So, we have already discussed the buccal cavity. What is this? This is the buccal cavity, right? So, here we have the buccal cavity. Just above that, what is this? This is the part of the respiratory tract. This is the external nair. Then after that, we have the nasal chamber. We are going to have two nasal opening, okay? So these are the external nair also we can see, nostril also we can see. Then after that, this is the internal nair, right? So this is called as the internal nair. We are going to have two internal nairs for both the two nostrils. So here the nasal chamber is separated from the buccal cavity by means of a bone, and what is the name of the bone? That is the palatine bone, right? Now after that, here where we have the food pipe and the windpipe, right? So here we are going to have the windpipe, understand? And here this is just behind the windpipe, we have the food pipe. So in this region, we are going to have this larynx, this is the sound box, and the apical region of the larynx, this is called as the glottis. So here, this is the larynx, this is one organ, right? So this larynx is the sound box where we can produce the sound. Then just here, the top of the larynx, this is called as the glottis, right? And above the glottis, there is a flap present. So that structure that is known as the epiglottis. Okay. So epiglottis is present just above the glottis. And this glottis is the opening of the larynx or the sound box or the voice box. So this is the windpipe, right? So this windpipe will open into both the lungs. So this is the windpipe. The another name of the windpipe, this is also called as the trachea, right? Now after that, just this is supposed the trachea. Just after the trachea, just behind the trachea, we are going to have the food pipe. This food pipe is also known as the esophagus, right? So remember that this is also known as the esophagus. So this esophagus, do it have any flap like structure? Yes, it is going to have a flap. And what is the name of the flap? This is called as the gullet. Okay, remember that the opening of the food pipe is known as the gullet, and the opening of the windpipe or the trachea, this is called as the epiglottis. Now, in this region where the buccal cavity and the internal nair opens, from that part up to the entering of the wind and the food into the food pipe and the windpipe, this region, this is known as the pharynx region. So, this pharynx is divided into three parts, right? Remember that the windpipe is, the pharynx region is divided into three parts. First of all, just see, we are going to have two nostrils, right? We are going to have two internal nairs. Both the two internal nairs, wherever it will open, right? So what is that called as? This is known as the nasopharynx, okay? So this is the nasopharynx where both the two internal nairs open, right? So here you can see the nasopharynx, what is it? This is the region where both the two internal nairs open. Remember that, right? This next part, that it is the opening of the Eustachian tube also. Now, what is the Eustachian tube? Remember that Eustachian tube is the opening of the middle ear. So, the middle ear is connected with the pharynx by one tube-like structure that is called as the Eustachian tube. So, opening of both the Eustachian tube, that will occur in the nasopharynx region. It is lined by one type of tissue, that is the ciliated columnar pseudostratified epithelium. So, here it is lined by this type of tissue, ciliated tissue, columnar tissue, and this is pseudostratified epithelium. Already in the tissue part, we have discussed what is the type of tissue here. So this is the nasopharynx open. Then after the nasopharynx, what is the next part? That is the oropharynx. So what is the oropharynx? Here we have the buccal cavity, right? Wherever we will take the food, we will chew the food. So just after that, the next part, this is called as the oropharynx. Oropharynx is actually the next part of the buccal cavity. So what is the oropharynx? See, oropharynx, the buccal cavity opens into the oropharynx. That means here this is the buccal cavity. Buccal cavity will open into the oropharynx. That means from the nasopharynx, just behind that, we are going to have the oropharynx. Now, this oropharynx is lined by non-keratinized squamous epithelium. This is the compound epithelium, right? Remember that this is the compound squamous epithelium, which is non-keratinized. In the skin, we have keratinized, but whenever it will go to the buccal cavity or the oropharynx, that or even the laryngopharynx also, this is the non-keratinized compound squamous epithelium. So this is the oropharynx. After the buccal cavity, we have the oropharynx. That means the food will pass from the buccal cavity into the oropharynx to the next part, that is to the food pipe. Now, the last part, what is the last part? This is just here in this region, we are going to have the next part, that is the laryngopharynx. Okay, so this is the laryngopharynx. Just above that, we are going to have the oropharynx. So this part is the oropharynx. And just above that, where both the two internal nares open, that will be known as the nasopharynx. So together, nasopharynx, oropharynx and laryngopharynx is combined and it is called as the pharynx as a whole. So what is the laryngopharynx? Well, it opens into near the trachea. So see, wherever the trachea will open in this region, we have the laryngopharynx. Next one, it is also lined by the same type of tissue, that is non-keratinized compound squamous epithelium. So it is also lined by the compound squamous non-keratinized epithelial tissue. So this is the laryngopharynx. Now you can see the pharynx region. This pharynx region is the common pathway for the entry of both food and the air. Okay, it is the common pathway for both air and the food. Okay, so just see what is it. First of all, whenever we take the air, so it will pass from this external nare, internal nare, then passing via the oropharynx, then laryngopharynx, and then it will enter into the windpipe. If it comes to the next part, that is the food we will take it with the mouth, then go to the buccal cavity, then via the oropharynx, it will enter into the food pipe. So here, this is the pharynx region where the food and the air, both of them, they are going to cross, they are going to have the same pathway from where both the food and the air have to pass out. So that's why whenever we're breathing, we cannot take the food. We cannot swallow whenever we inspirate, suppose. Try to take a breath, and whenever you are breathing, we cannot take the food. And whenever we are swallowing, whenever suppose you just try to swallow, then breathing stops, right? So why this is happening? Because we have a common space. So at a time, only one thing can pass. Either it is food or it is air. So this is the common pathway where the food and the air have to cross, have to pass, right? So this is the common pathway for both air and the food, right? Remember that this is the pharynx. Now, this is the pharynx region, which is also this is the doorway of the entry of the foreign particle into our body through air or through food. Both these two that will come from outside. So that's why the foreign particle will also enter. And in this region, this is just the doorway where from where it can enter inside our body, right? So that's why in the pharynx region, we are going to have a ring of lymphoid tissue. And that ring-like structure where actually we have number of lymphoid tissues, they are called as the tonsils, right? So let's just see the tonsils here. So what are the tonsils? These are nothing but the lymphoid tissue, right? So remember that this is the lymphoid tissue. This is present in a ring-like manner, and this region where in the pharynx region the lymphoid tissue are present or the tonsils are present in a ring-like manner, that is called as the Walther's ring. Okay, so let us see this means. That means in the pharynx region, like a ring, we are going to have the lymphoid tissues or the tonsils. Now, what are the tonsils? I will draw here. Suppose here in this region, we have a transverse section. So if you have a transverse section and you see from the top, then how we will see. Okay, so this is the ring, right? So in this ring, what we are going to see is, first of all, this is the first tonsil, okay? Then the second tonsil, this is the Eustachian tube, okay? So here, this is the Eustachian tube. Then here, then this is another, this is the next tonsil, and here, this is the last tonsil, okay? So first of all, what is this? Here in this region, we are going to have the unpaired tonsil. What is that? This is known as the lingual tonsil. Okay, so this is the lingual tonsil. Just behind the tongue it is present, right? Just above that, here in this region, we are going to have the palate. So this part, this is the next part. This is the palate region where we have the next paired tonsil. What is this? This is the palatine tonsil. Okay, this is the palatine tonsil. Just above that, here in this region, we have the ear. Isn't that what I told, that in the region of the nasopharynx, both the two Eustachian tube opens. So here we have the two Eustachian tube. Just above the Eustachian tube, we are going to have the next tonsil. What is this? Here you can see this is one, this is another. This is also paired tonsil. What is that tonsil called? This is called as the tubal tonsil. Okay. This is called as the tubal tonsil. And here on this back region, this is the unpaired tonsil. What is that called? So this is the unpaired tonsil. This is known as the pharyngeal tonsil. Okay. So this is the pharyngeal tonsil. Right, just above that we have the windpipe and the footpipe. So footpipe and windpipe are present, but in the tonsil region we have the lingual tonsil, then the palatine tonsil, tubal tonsil, and then the pharyngeal tonsil. You can see the numbers, how many tonsils they form the Walther's ring. See, we have the unpaired pharyngeal tonsil and we have the unpaired lingual tonsil. That means lingual tonsil and the pharyngeal tonsil, they are unpaired. But the palatine and the tubal, they are palatine here also it is present, here also it is present, tubal here also it is present, here also it is present. So this tubal, they are the paired tonsils, right? So how many tonsils they will form the Walther's ring? They are 6 in numbers. And from that, 2 of them they're paired. 2 into 2 is equal to 4. And 2 of them they're unpaired. That means 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. So we have 2 unpaired tonsils. They're pharyngeal and the lingual. And 2 paired tonsils. They are the tubal and palatine. I hope you understand the pharynx region. So that is all about the pharynx. So remember the pharynx that is divided into 3 parts. What are they? They are nasopharynx, oropharynx, and laryngopharynx. The internal nest that will open into the nasopharynx. The buccal cavity will open into the oropharynx. And just above the windpipe, we have the laryngopharynx. So that's all about the pharynx region where both the food and the, this is the common pathway where both the food and the wind, they have to cross, they have to pass and enter into their respective tubes, respective pipes. They are the windpipe and the foot pipe. Windpipe is also known as trachea, and foot pipe, this is also known as the esophagus. So that's all about the pharynx. I hope you understand. That's all about the video. Thank you.